Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 24 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we are going to put everything we learned in the previous lesson about maps into practice using code. First, we will cover a nil map, then an empty map, writing to a map, and then reading from a map. So let's begin. A nil map is something that is not initialized and doesn't store any values. We can create a nil map using variable declaration, so let's create one. Here we have a nil map with name, name age, which is a map of type with string keys and int values. If we try to get a length of the nil map, it will be 0. So let's try it. FMT println len name age. Let's run our program and see what the length is. As expected, the length is 0. Reading from a nil map with any key will return the 0 value for the value type. So if we try to read anything from name age, it will return a 0. I can do FMT name age. And inside, notice that I'm using square brackets after the variable name or the map variable name, and inside I can provide the key that I need to get the value from. So this should get us the value of key foo in the map name age. So let's run our program and see what the output is. As you can see, it returns 0 value for the int data type or the value data type. So no matter whatever you want to read, it will always return 0. Because it's a nil map which hasn't been initialized and there are no values. Another thing we covered about nil map was that if you try to add values to the nil map, it will cause a panic. Adding value is similar to how we read values. So name age followed by square brackets, the key I want to add the value for, foo, and then the value. I'm just going to comment this out to prevent the error. And now if we run our program, you will see we got a panic. Assignment to entry in a nil map. As we discussed in the lesson, when reading from a nil map, it will always return a 0 value for the value data type, and trying to write to a nil map will cause a panic. Let's clear the console here, and I am going to remove this statement as well. I'm just going to add a comment here to say it's a nil map. Next, let us look at creating empty maps, or maps that are initialized but no values in them. There are a few ways of doing that, and let's look at all of them one by one. First, we have the variable shorthand. Here, I have declared a name age map again with key of type string and values int. The length of the empty map, similar to the nil map, is 0. So I can do fmt println len name age. Let's run a program and see what the output is. As expected, the output is 0. So this is one way of doing it using variable shorthand. Next, we can also create an empty map using the make function. So I can say name age colon equals make, then the type of the map, map with string keys and int values. Again, this will create an empty map. So if we run a program, we will expect the same output, which is 0. As expected, we are getting the 0 length printed. Just going to comment this out. Another way to create an empty map is to use long variable declaration or literal variable declaration. I can say var name age is of type map with string keys and int values, and then assign it a empty map, map, string keys and int values, then initialize it. This too is an empty map, so if we run a program, we will see 0 printed for the length of the map. The len function prints the number of key values stored in the map. As we expected, we get a 0. So I'm going to comment this out and move on to our next section, which is writing to a map. So I'm going to create and initialize a map with the variable shorthand. Name age colon equal map of key type string and int values, and then curly braces to initialize it. To add values to a map, we use similar syntax as array or slices, that is square brackets. But inside the square brackets, instead of putting in the index, we put in the key. So if I want to assign a key a value, I can do something like this. Name age, I want to assign value to key foo, and the value is 25. Since we have added a value to the map, we can expect the len function to return 1. As you see, len function output is 1. I can add as many values as I want, there's no limit to it. So I can say name age bar is equal to 30. And I can say name age foo bar is equal to 45. And now, since we have added 3 values to it, the len function should return 3. So as we expected, we are getting 3 printed to the console. So that's basically how you add values to a map. If we wanted, we could have initialized map with some initial values. To initialize a map, when declaring, you can say a and then colon and then the value you want to put. A has age of 24, b has age of 30, c has age of 60. So here, I created a map name age of string keys and int values, and I initialized the map with three values, that is key A holding the value 24, key B holding the value 30, key C holding the value 60. And after that, I added some more values to the map using the square brackets and the key. So now if we try to get the length of the map, we should expect 6 printed to the console since we added 6 values to the map name age. As expected, we are getting 6 printed. So this is how we add values to the map. So next, let us look at reading from a map. I'm just going to remove the print statement to print the length of the map. Reading from the map is very similar to writing. The notation we used for writing is how we read from a map. So if I wanted to read the value for key C in the map, I could do fmt println name of the map, name age, and then inside it provide the key. So I want to get value for the key C. As you can see, C has a value of 60, so we should expect 60 printed to the console. As we expected, 60 is printed to the console. I can provide any key I want the value for, so I can do foo bar and we should expect 45 printed to the console. That's correct, 45 of printed to the console. As I mentioned earlier, if you try to provide a key that doesn't have a value in the map, it will get 0 value for the value data type, which is int in our case, so it will return 0. Since x is not present in the map, we should expect 0 to be printed to the console when we run the program. As expected, since x is not a key inside the map, 0 is printed to the console. Another point to remember is that maps can only have unique keys. So let's revert this back to C. Here, we assigned the value 60. I'm just going to create a copy of this statement. And then before the last statement, I'm going to do name age key C value 70. So what I am saying is, in the name age map, add a key C with value 70. But since we already have a key C and maps can only have a unique key, when we do this, it will override the existing value and then will store 70 for C. Let's run our program and see what the output is. As you can see, before we overwrote it, the value was 60, but after we overwrote it, the value is 70, which is as we expected. Just to recap, you can only have unique keys in a map. Next, let us look at comma OK idiom. We have seen already that if a key doesn't exist, you will always get the 0 value for the value data type. So in our case, since the value data type is int, if the key doesn't exist, we always get 0 printed. So what if you actually want to store a value, that is 0, in the map? So I'm going to create a new map name grade, which stores grade of the student against their name. So I can do map string as the key and int as the value and initialize it with curly braces. Let's add some seed values or some initial values to it. Foo had a grade of 10, bar had a grade of 9, foo bar had a grade of 8, and another student X didn't appear for the exam, so they got a grade of 0. Let's comment these statements out so that we don't get a lot of noise. Now I want to read the grade for X. Fmt println name grade, and I want the value for key X. As you can see, 0 is printed to the console. Now in your program, how would you know if the value actually existed or if it's just returning the 0 value for the value data type? This is where the comma OK idiom comes into play. Reading from a map returns two values. First is the actual value for the key, and then the next is the boolean value to indicate if the value existed in the map or not. So I can do grade X, read from the name grade map, provide the key X, and then print grade X. Since reading from a map returns two value, I can say OK. And here we print the value of OK to see what the value is. Let's run our program and see what outputs we get. As you can see, it printed the value of 0 for key X, which is correct, and also returned a value true for OK, which means it actually found a value inside the map. So with OK, you can compare and be sure that the value actually existed in the map. Here, if I replace X with some key that doesn't exist, let's say Y, then I run a program, we should see 0 still being printed since the key doesn't exist, but along with it, we will see the value of OK is false, again since the key doesn't exist. As you can see, false was printed to indicate that the key Y doesn't exist in the map name grid, and the value returned is a zero value for the value data type, that is int. Before we move on to next lesson, I just wanted to show that you can create maps with keys that are of comparable type and values of any type. I can do A is a map of type int and value int. That's fine too. I can replace the int key with string as we have already seen, but since slice is not a comparable data type, we can't do int slice as a key. But if I wanted, I can do int slice as the value. So here in this map, we can say foo has grades int slice 1, 2, 3, 4. That is valid. So just remember, the key data type should be anything that's comparable. Example, int, floats, strings, etc. But you cannot have slices in here because they are not of comparable data type. But for value type, you can have anything you want. And if I print the map fmt println a, run a program, you can see we see a map where key is foo and the value is a int slice with values 1, 2, 3, 4. Here the IDE is suggesting that I can remove this from the map declaration because it's already inferred from the map value type. So that will work too. That's it for the lesson. In this lesson, first we covered nil map and how to create one using the var declaration. Then we looked at creating empty maps using variable shorthand, the make function, the literal variable declaration. Next, we looked at creating a map and initializing it with some values. Next, we looked at how to add values or key values pair into the map, followed by how using a duplicate value will overwrite the existing value if the key already exists. Lastly, we looked at the comma OK idiom, which tells us if the value return actually existed in the map or if it's just a zero value for the value data type. I would suggest you to practice these things on your own and see if you can make it work. If you have any questions, please reach out by posting a comment under the video or through our Discord server. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. I will see you in the next lesson. Happy coding.